animated be right back screen or scene or overlays. There's a thing in the Twitch community that pretty much every new streamer might think that, hey, if I want to have an animated overlay, it has to be motion graphics. It has to be made in a compositing software with a lot of complicated stuff. An animated overlay can be absolutely anything, as long as it's in a video format or an image sequence. And today we're gonna create just that. We will be recording a short video that will serve as an animated overlay. In this case, it's gonna be a be right back screen. Hey guys, GetLevel here, and I'm always trying to find new creative ways to make things accessible to people. So in this video, there will be no editing software at all, no Adobe Premiere, no Adobe products at all, no DaVinci Resolve, no HitFilm Express, no Filmora, nothing. None of that. We're gonna be creating everything using our camera and our broadcasting software. The principle is very, very simplistic. We're gonna hold something in front of the camera to get everything else out of focus, and this will be the spot that will say whatever message we want, be right back, for example. And then we will use the out of focus spot to display stuff like our chat or the labels bars, for example. Now, if you're already panicking, thinking, oh my God, I don't have a camera that has such a good autofocus, do not panic. I will show you how to do it with the C920, which is a camera that, believe it or not, has a very, very good focus point when it comes to putting stuff close to it. All right, but now a quick message from our sponsor right before we start. This portion of the video is sponsored by Owned. Owned is your one-stop shop for anything customizable that a YouTuber or live streamer will need. You want a dope, fully animated overlay pack? They got you. Some of the packs even include PSD files that you can really customize to your liking. You want separate assets such as offline images, webcam overlays, stinger transitions, alert designs, and alert sounds? They got you. You want to create custom emotes? Spend 2 minutes making a character that looks like you, and then let Owned generate the rest. I told you, they got you. You wanna create sub badges? They got you with their custom sub badge maker. Oh what, you don't wanna make anything? That's fine. They also have pre-mades that you can select from. You want custom graphics for your Twitch channel points and rewards? They got you. You want bid badges? They got you. You wanna make a dope profile picture? They got an avatar maker and a gaming logo maker. You wanna make a channel trailer or a custom YouTube intro? They have a channel trailer maker. No need for editing at all. Oh, so you want a YouTube banner too? They got you. There's a lot of other things that they do, but I'll let you figure it out by going to own.gg/getlevel. That is own3d.gg/getlevel. As I said in my previous videos, Owned is actually having a huge sale for the holidays. They're having a big sale for Black Friday, the Black Friday week, and pretty much the whole month of December up until Christmas. So check it out. That is both Owned Pro, which is the plugin for OBS Studio, and also Owned Normal, which is all the assets that you need to customize your live streams. So check out both links in the description. So let's begin. Your broadcasting software most likely has the ability to record, and that's what we're gonna use today in order to make our be right back screen. In fact, I'm actually using OBS Studio to record this video right now. It gets a little bit of snow, that's my browser source. If you wanna know how to do that, watch my previous video. But since I'm already using OBS Studio to record, I have to use another software to show you. And I'll be using Streamlabs OBS, but you do not need Streamlabs OBS to do this, okay? That's a good thing that I have Streamlabs OBS open, because that shows you an example of my be right back screen on my actual stream. This is what I use. And this was made using pretty much the same technique that I'm gonna show you today. I just recorded a video of myself. Then of course I added a little bit of motion graphics, but the main core of this whole be right back screen is just me standing there looking at the camera, and those twirly things in my glasses, this is just me looking at a YouTube video on my laptop, holding it in front of me in order to have the reflections on the glasses. So this is the type of creative thinking that I want to share with you guys. Okay, so I created a whole new scene. I have my camera there, and that's pretty much all I need. I know that I want to be able to hold something in front of the camera, so we're gonna cut a little piece of paper. Okay, so it's gonna be just a thin white strip of paper, and I know that within my broadcasting software, I'll be able to add the text. Now, obviously with this type of be right back scene or whatever, it's cooler if you have a bunch of lights in the background, if your setup already looks good, of course, but even if it doesn't, to be fair, since everything's gonna be out of focus, it will still look cool. And bloop, there we go. Since I'm using a ring light, the light is facing here, won't be able to see that this is from a little notepad, so it will be completely white, just like this. There you go. And as you can see, it blurs the background. That is if you have autofocus on. If you're using a webcam that does not allow you to move the focus, unfortunately, this specific video does not apply to you. But again, I'll show you how to do it with the C920, okay? Now we're just gonna check our settings to make sure that our recording is going to be high quality, high bitrate. In Streamlabs, I believe that it's not. Yeah, let me go just 1080p. 30 FPS should be fine. You don't have to go too crazy with it, but let's go with 6K. Just keep in mind that this will show up on your stream. So if you stream at 720p or at like 3K bitrate, there's no need to go higher than that. Right here where it says recording path, if you're doing this with OBS Studio, same thing, go to your settings, make sure that recording is enabled and you're having high quality basically. And we know that the record button is right there. So let's just grab our piece of paper. And in this case, something that we also need to remember is that it's going to loop, okay? It's going to be in a loop. So if you record the video and you do this, and then you do that, it's gonna cut back to when you started, okay? So try to keep things, you can move, obviously it's better if you move, it's even better if there's some sort of light changing and stuff like that, but ultimately you wanna kinda stay in the same position just to avoid like this cut when it actually loops. You can record pretty much whatever, technically you can record whatever length that you want. But in this case, we're gonna record a couple of seconds just to make sure that we're not putting a huge load on our broadcasting software by playing a file that's like a couple gigs, right? And keep your finger ready. You can even do a little test record. Ooh, I'm recording right now. 1, 2, 3. And then you can go check your directory to make sure that, okay, it's really recording. Check the quality. There you go, all Gucci. All right, so now, let's just make it happen, right? You can see how the bokeh is affecting. That's like the autofocus lights, basically, by the distance. So as close as you can put it, the more bokeh you will get. And go. Okay, now let's check the video to see if I did it right. And something we can do here straight in media player is click here and click repeat. And we see what the loop will look like basically. I actually don't like it. The movement maybe was a bad idea. And I think I'm maybe a little too close to the camera. I still want to be able to distinguish what's going on a little bit behind. Now, if you want to add that to OBS Studio, for example, you would have to go click on the plus here on the sources, go to media source, and then find that video that you just made. Browse and find it. Okay, click open. And once you click open, you will want to click on loop because this is what is going to make it loop. And there you go. Click open, loop, click okay. So just for the sake of this video, since I'm recording with OBS Studio, I'm gonna show you how to do it in Streamlabs OBS. It is literally the same thing. You click plus to add a source. That's all you need to know. Anyways, let's turn this off. Let's click add. Let's click media. Let's find media source. Same thing. You can name it if you want. Okay. Click loop and then just click okay. Now, the cool thing here is that this is a source just like any other source. That means that we can apply filters if we want. Good filter for media is like color correction, for example, if you want to bump like the saturation, if you have a black and white, if you want a black and white layout and then put whatever it is in there, you can bump up the saturation way too much if you want to. You can also play with the hue that will like shift the colors. And you can also add an extra color in there. That is something that you'll have to play around with. There you go. If you want to make it just one single color, you can do that, right? My color scheme is purple and cyan. I can make that happen. Anyways, we're not going to use that here. We're going to delete the color correction and we're going to close this. Okay, so now we need to add some text. We're going to click plus, click text GDI, same thing in OBS Studio. And now we're going to type we're gonna bump up the font size because that's important. And we're gonna go find a cool font. You can get fonts on the internet. There's cool websites like thefont.com, I believe, where you can download and install font on your computer. And from there, you just, you know, find something that you like. HBM Bridge, I like that one. But also remember the format of this, because this is super long and this is a little shorter. We don't want it to have to be super small. So you might want to add some lines there, or maybe you want to just type BRB if it's easier. I want it to be centered, so I'm gonna scroll down a little bit. Alignment, center, like this. And of course, since the paper is white, we're gonna choose a contrasting color. In that case, we can color pick. I don't know if that's available with OBS Studio, but it is available with Streamlabs OBS. Unlock, click done, and just place it somewhere where it doesn't necessarily go out of frame. Okay, doesn't have to be huge. There we go, it's fine like that. Okay, now let's say that you wanted to add your chat to the right side. Let's go find chat box in the widgets. Of course, this will be different for OBS Studio, unless you're using a plugin that gives you your chat box, but you might have to add it as a browser source. But this is not a tutorial on how to add your chat. The tutorial on how to make this video and use it as a BRB back screen. Okay, let's make the chat a little thinner, maybe. That should do it. Let's see what the chat looks like. Here we can right click on the chat box, go to transform and center vertical. Okay, that way we know it's centered here. Okay, technically you could be done here, but if you want to add an actual, like a little border to the chat, a little background to the chat, you can create a color source. Okay, color source. Same thing in OBS Studio. I believe if you click plus here, you will find color source, okay? Add source, and let's make it this color. All right, we're gonna move it pretty much the size of our chat. I'm gonna hold shift to stretch it. Usually I don't advise people stretching anything, but in this case, it's just a color source, so we're not deforming any pixels really. Put that behind the chat box and then place your chat box kind of in the middle. Bear with me, I know it doesn't look like much right now. Now we're gonna right click on the color source, add filter, add a color correction, click done, and lower the opacity. This at 100%, lower the opacity like a lot. Just barely make it visible here. And now you have your chat box. If you really wanna make this a whole thing and you wanna make a whole theme, originally I just wanted to show you how to make a normal overlay, but let's go all the way, okay? I'm gonna click that color source, I'm gonna click copy, I'm gonna right click that color source again, and I'm gonna duplicate it. So that's now a different source. And now I'm gonna go ahead and stretch it again, and we're gonna create our labels, right? We're gonna create our labels here. I'm gonna make it pretty wide so that it's really visible. Nice, I'm gonna click on the plus. I'm gonna go find stream labels. That is on Streamlabs OBS. Again, I'm connected with my Twitch account, so I have access to my labels. I think if you're using OBS Live, you will have access to your labels. If you're using Own Pro, for example, using my link in the description, you will have access to your labels also. And then here, I wanna put my recent sub. If I really wanted to, I could change the font. Which font are we using here? Yeah, let's use the font. Font family, and it was HBM, boom. Have this, we'll change the color to a dark gray. I'm gonna right click this stream label, click filters, click plus to add a new filter, go to scroll, make it scroll, and then we're gonna decide on a width, limit width here. We're gonna decide which width we want it to have. It's 400 something, no, maybe too much. 250, should be fine. And we're gonna give it a little bit of horizontal speed. Okay, nice, but no, wait, we're not done. We wanted to make semi-transparent, so click plus again to add a new color correction filter and lower the brightness, just to make it kind of match this whole box thing here. But we're going with some sort of a theme. Let's click done. Okay, now we're gonna right click this label, click copy, right click this label again, paste a duplicate, again a different one. Make sure you remember what that number is, so 1012. Place it here, can't see, that's fine. You can use the arrows on your keyboard to move it around. And we're gonna do that thing again, right click, paste duplicate, and we're gonna place that one over there. Get that pepper off of that. Okay, make sure it's 1012, looking here, nice. Now I'm gonna double click that second label because we don't want the same name every time. Most recent subscriber, let's put most recent cheerer, it's right there, recent cheerer. Good, boom, everything is good. Double click on this and put most top donator, most recent donator. Let's do that. Okay, boom. I'm thinking maybe the blue is not the best for this. Let me find my text, double click it. Whoop. There we go. And we're gonna give it the same dark gray treatment. Remember that if you want this to scroll, you can also do that, right? You can just right click, add a filter, and maybe you want it to scroll from top to bottom. In that case, you would want to add some vertical speed, minus vertical speed. There we go. Of course, it's not perfect, but hey, we did all of that within the broadcasting software. That's not bad. Now, when it comes to the labels, moving them a little bit with my arrows, you could download some icons here, like a star for most recent sub. You could put a dollar sign for most recent donation. You can put a diamond for most recent cheer. All right, the goal here is to really show that you don't need any editing software. Your broadcasting software is already super powerful. So if you want to create stuff like that, it is absolutely possible. Now, in case you have a Logitech C920, I want to show you how you can move the focus. Well, technically, if you have autofocus, all you have to do is put your, you know, put your piece of paper in front of the webcam. But if you don't, then this is how you would do it. Let me add a new scene for that. Oh, look at that fancy transition. Let's add a new video capture device. Well, this one, C920. Hopefully that works. Yes, here we are. Hi. Okay, let's go with custom. Maybe not 2K. 1080p should be fine. Ooh, ooh. Okay, now we can test to see if we have autofocus by putting our fingers close to the camera. And as you can see, the focus doesn't change. The focus is currently on my lights right there. Does not change at all. So we could right click on it. If you're not using Logitech G Hub, for example, right click on it, go to configure video. You'll have another dialog box here and then go to focus. There we go. This should modify it. Put your piece of paper the way that you want it to show and move the focus until this is in focus. You could use the whole preview if you want to. You might want to avoid having auto exposure. That's why it's, you know, now it's bright, now it's darker, blah, blah, blah. You can turn that off if you want to. And there you go. You have a very close focus with the C920. And it will also react to lights. We talked about the bokeh. I can't move this because I have it in a weird setup. As you can see behind me, you can see the bokeh. Oh, there you go. And that's the C920. And my hands are in focus there. That's a webcam. So you can create that type of imagery, if you will. Look at that. Look at that close focus on there. So you can create that type of imagery using a webcam too. Not all of webcams can do it, but C920, which is the most popular one, 1080p, can absolutely do it. So that was a closer look at how you can create scenes with using just your camera and your broadcasting software. You already have all the tools at your disposition. The only limitation here is your imagination. But understand, if you don't want to put in the work, that's completely fine. I got you covered. If you go to gumroad.com/getlevel, there's a bunch of fully animated overlay packs and also static overlay packs. A bunch of them are free. The rest is very affordable. So check them out if you want to just install overlays immediately and be good to go. That being said, if you have any questions about all the things that I showed right here, you can leave them in a comment section below. I also have a Discord server that if you want to join and, you know, network a little bit, there's a bunch of streamers there. And if you have questions about streaming in general, there's like 1,000 of us. We can answer your questions and maybe you can answer ours too. If you end up doing something similar than what I showed in this video, please post it on Twitter and then tag me there. I'm @level_photo on Twitter. And while you're at it, you know, follow my Instagram. Again, for some free and cheap overlays, gumroad.com/getlevel. Shout out to Renzito for retweeting my video. Retweet this video to maybe get a shout out in the next one. But for now, top right, you will see what YouTube thinks is the best video for you to watch next. And at the bottom of it, you will find my most recent video. So go check them out and keep on learning about live streaming. That being said, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud. Get level out.